Hi friends, today I am going to discuss a little about multiple myeloma. Multiple myeloma, it means it is a malignant neoplasm of plasma cells. It is mainly occurs in elderly people 60 years or above. It is characterized by the appearance of M protein, that means a monoclonal protein in serum. Generally, these plasma cells are derived from B lymphocytes. In turn, plasma cells secrete immunoglobulins. Immunoglobulins are important for fighting and defending against any infection. Generally, polyclonal immunoglobulins are secreted by plasma cells. In this type of disorder, monoclonal antibodies are formed. Generally, two light chains and two heavy chains are required in an immunoglobulin. In this, a single light chain even is able to form an immunoglobulin. Or immunoglobulin fragments like kappa or lambda fragments are present. Coming to its immunopathology, bone marrow is infiltrated with aggregates of abnormal plasma cells. As plasma cells number is more, it infiltrates the bone marrow. These neoplastic plasma cells are maybe mature or immature, leading to multifocal destructive bone lesions. These plasma cells activates the osteoclast activation factor in bone marrow. This results in lytic bone lesions. As these plasma cells infiltrate the bone marrow, there is little space left in the bone marrow, which causes anemia, neutropenia, and thrombocytopenia. As lytic lesions in bone is occur with the activation of osteoclast activation factor, there is hypercalcemia, and also the patient is more prone to pain and fracture. Then coming to the investigations, there is a classic triad of investigations of myeloma, which requires at least two of the following abnormalities, which is more than 10% of plasma cells are present in the bone marrow, histologically proven plasma cell infiltration in the bone marrow, and M protein, that is monoclonal immunoglobulin light chains in blood or urine. This is the second one, and osteolytic bone lesions is the third one. At least two of these must present to obtain a diagnosis of multiple myeloma. Generally, the treatment is before coming to treatment, the most important protein to remember in this multiple myeloma is Benz-Jones light chain protein. These Benz-Jones are light chain proteins, and these are easily precipitated by kidney. And it causes a renal failure. As there is a defect in secretion of normal immunoglobulin, ineffective defense against infection. That is, we can't defend against any infection. So, the patient is subjected to have recurrent infections. And also hyperviscosity is seen because of increased number of plasma cells, raised ESR, Rolux formation is seen, that is RBC casts are seen. Hyperviscosity is another feature. Coming to bleeding tendency. Patient manifests with the bleeding disorders because of platelets gets coated by these monoclonal proteins, which impairs the adhesion and aggregation of platelets. These are some clinical features of multiple myeloma. As we already discussed about diagnostic criteria, which is more than 10% plasma cells in the bone marrow, that is plasma cell infiltration into the bone marrow, and elevated M protein in serum and urine, and also the evidence of lytic bone lesions. These three form the classic triad of diagnostic criteria of multiple myeloma. Coming to the treatment, the treatment is generally chemotherapy with a combination of methylene and prednisolone. prednisone and other some chemotherapeutic agents. Thank you for watching the video.